Greetings, greetings. It's Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thank you for looking at my video. I'm going to talk about antibiotic resistance, or the alarming reports we're getting now on Google for antibiotic resistance. You know what? I've been beating this drum for 30 plus years. I was jumping up and down and telling people not to take antibiotics 30 plus years ago because I said the future's going to be looking bad in terms of medicine. We're going to get a lot of resistance coming up, and it's exactly what's happening now. In fact, it's happening a lot faster than we realize. If you're watching this video, I'd like you to really understand that taking antibiotics is not a clever move in many situations. Many infections can be resolved by other means, yet we're very, very quick to jump on an antibiotic. Even for small, very tiny little self-limiting problems, we jump on antibiotics. And I can appreciate why you folks out there would be quick to jump on one, because you don't understand a lot about, you know, these kind of matters, the way people like me think about them. Antibiotics, in my mind, would have to be one of the most powerful, strongest drugs ever created. And I can guarantee you that the day will come in medicine and in science in general when they look back on this episode in history and realize how stupid they were and how crazy they were for actually creating drugs that create so much death and disability with people. I just can't understand why so many people don't get it through their head how devastating these drugs are. Half my time in the clinic is spent cleaning up this kind of mess. In almost every single case I see of a person with a very, very poor gut health, an antibiotic will underpin this poor gut function. I've seen it not once, not twice, not 1,000 times, not 5,000 times, probably 20,000 times. I've seen it so much. And not just been working with people with this problem. I've worked with many physicians who specialize in cleaning people up after antibiotics. I've been to many conferences and heard doctors talking, you know, telling their colleagues to stop prescribing so many antibiotics. But all these things fall on deaf ears. To me, it's a little bit like what Donald Trump's doing at the moment. Everything's being stonewalled and whitewashed when it comes to the environment at the moment, and the way that the global temperatures are changing. We're not fools. We can all see this. But many people put their head under the sand and pretend nothing's happening. And even when things get really bad one day and we realize it's too late, what then? I mean, you know, we're all part and parcel of this, I take it. We're all part and parcel of it. So the point I'm trying to make in this video is try not to take an antibiotic in most situations, unless you've got a life-threatening disease and your specialist tells you you really need to take one. But I can guarantee you now, in 8 or 9 out of 10 cases, they're not required. So, yeah, think about it carefully. Read more online about how dangerous these drugs are. Don't listen to me. Listen to other people. Listen to many other people. And be scared, be very scared about the future in terms of, you know, infections. If you keep using these drugs yourself, your ability for something to really work may become very impaired in the future. I'm particularly passionate about children being very careful with antibiotics, messing up their gut. Kids respond beautifully to natural treatments. There are many different natural medicines we can use that effectively clean up the gut and the bloodstream and the lymphatic system. We don't need to rely on antibiotics anymore. We've got high tech now behind natural medicines. We can standardize natural herbs now to make them as powerful, if not more powerful, than antibiotics. But it all comes down to money. And that's the sad thing. So you think about it. I'm warning people out there again, like I have been in the past, to be very careful with antibiotic usage. Thank you for tuning in.